I like to use two videos to introduce how can we use TI Portal and 1200 PLC to control the stack motors. This is Siemens custom effective, the low and the middle end small PLC, i7-1200 PLC. And I will use the custom effective stack motor driver, usually it called microstabber driver. And I will use the industrial stack motor. And I will use TI Portal technology object to show how can we config this PTO hypothesis output in this video. And in the previous video, I introduced one topic. So usually those microstep driver, their default control signal, their power will be 5 volt. But in the industrial area, while using PLC to control those microstepper drivers, the PLC side of the signal will supply 24 voltage. So to allow the 24 control signal, the pulse signal, direction signal, and enable signal to connect from the PLC side to those microstepper drivers, we need to connect one resistor to limit the current around those channels like this. The pulses, direction, and enable. Pulses, direction, and enable. And the left side and the right side, those are two different styles. Left side, for the digital output channel, this is the current sync style. Usually it called PNP output. Typically Japanese PLC, they commonly use this way, sync digital output. But most of common way, we will use the right side way. The digital output of the PLC will use the source, the current source. So each channel will supply the current from inside to outside. Doing this way, the stack motor driver side, we will use the common ground like this. And to limit the current, the resistor, we would use 2 to 4K ohm to limit the current while using the 24 voltage. For more details of those current and the resistor selection, please review the previous video. And in this video, we will mainly talk about how can we use the TI Portal software and the 1200 PLC to control the stack motor running. But before that, I will briefly reveal how can we do the wiring. So even if you haven't got a chance to review the previous video, you can still use this one video to have a rough idea how can we do the hardware wiring, how can we config the TO, the technology object channel, and how can we use program to control the step driver and the step motors. All right, let me briefly reveal the wiring portion first. In this system, I have Siemens 1200 DC-DC-DC PLC. And I have this step motor, this driver. And this step motor is backup step motor, is a little bit huge. But actually, they are running the similar role as any other this small step motor still. Okay, they all have A plus, A minus, B plus, B minus. The only key difference is the torque value. And now let's go to the detail of this step motor driver. We can see it has SP, or basically, this is a high pulses input, and this is direction, and this is the enable. And this area, this couple terminals, this A plus, A minus, B plus, B minus, the wires from the stack motor, they have A plus, A minus, B plus, B minus, four wires. So they are connecting here. And this is the power. So in this system, I'm connecting 24 voltage at here. Typically, those low cost driver, their enable signal default, they enabled already. If we give on signal to the enable, actually that disable the drive. Okay, this need to take care. That's why if we reveal most of the drawings or any other videos in YouTube, you will see this enable, they are not enabled. They are not connecting everything. That's because default, once we give a pulses to this input, actually, your motor can be enabled. Typically, those low-cost driver is designed like this way. I think it's easy for the user because most of cases for the new learner or for the starter, they will forget wiring anything on this input. So take care, your drive default is enabled. So like in this case, I also not wiring anything on this enabled. So like this, this enable signal, it is here, okay? And then another two important signal, one is the high pulses here. So in this driver, it named SP, side point.
and the direction DIR here. Typically, from the PLC side, we need two outputs. Take care, your outputs cannot be the relay outputs. Your PLC output must be the transistor outputs. Take care. So your transistor output can deliver the high pulses to the side point of this. Okay? And the direction signal, you could use the relay output. But for the high pulses here, you have to use the transistor output. In this case, I'm using the output 0.0, this white wire, and then go to this hall pulses, this SP plus here. And as I introduced, in this system, I'm connecting this resistor here. I'm using this 1.8K, this resistors. Okay, I'm connecting here. So typically, this white wire from the PLC output connect to this resistor, and then this resistor connect to this plus, this high pulses input, okay? And the minus connect to this PLC minus. So take care, their ground, their minus need to be connected together. Same as your power, this ground, this minus here. And then the direction, the same idea. So my PLC output, point one, the second channel, this brown, this wire connect to here, and then this connect to this resistor and connect to this direction plus, okay? So I can use my PLC to control the direction of the motor, okay? Again, this enable, I'm not wiring anything because this driver default is enabled. Then for those deep switches, it totally depends on your application. For instance, in this case, firstly, let's look at this switch 2, 3, 4. So it's showing micro steps. Most of cases, your step motor will have 200 steps for one revolution. That means if the PLC send 200 pulses default, so your motor will spin one revolution. And 200 steps for one revolution, that means every pulse, the motor will run 1.8 degree. This 1.8 degree is basically a little bit high. So if you send 200 steps, 200 pulses for one revolution, you will hear your motor definitely not super smooth. So to run the motor more smoothly, so we will do the micro steps. Basically, we can split one step into multiple micro steps. Typically, the micro step, we could use the 32 micro steps. That means for one revolution, that is 200 multiply 32 pulses for your motor. So the more numbers of those micro steps, basically, in theory, your motor could run much smoother. However, you also need to take care of one thing. So the more pulses for one revolution, that means your speed basically will be limited in a certain range. For example, if your PLC output, the highest hertz is 100K hertz.
We can do this calculation. The PLC highest pulse, this is 100K per second. And per revolution, the step motor, the micro step, is 200 multiplied 32. This is the per revolution. Then we can calculate per second. This motor roughly can run highest speed is 15 revolutions. Then the RPM is equal to 15 multiply 60. It's 900 RPM.
So your speed and the smooth of the motor, this need to be trade-off. So in this case, I'm using 32, 1 over 32 micro step. That's why I'm using 110. So that's why the deep switch 2, 3, 4, I'm using 110 here, 110. And in some cases, you will see your driver will also show a reduced rate or current. It's showing 1 means 25%, 0 means 50% to deliver the stationary torque for the motor. Then, more important is a current delivery. So for example, if I'm using this small motor, this motor is a 1.5 ampere and a 0.7 newton meter. So that means we better limit the current from this driver. For example, for this small motor 1.5, So I could select this 1.5. This big motor, it is 5 ampere motor. But because this is the empty load, no any load there, so I'm selecting the 3.5, 011 in this case. So I'm using this 011 deep switch. So I set 3.5 ampere. So to drive this motor, this is enough. Okay, so this is the micro driver for the step motor driver. So typically the important thing is the pulse's input and direction and the load setting and micro steps. Micro step, you definitely do count something. This we introduced already. Okay, now let's shift to the TI portal and let me introduce how can we configure the PLC. Okay, let's shift to the TI portal. Let me introduce some details configuration there.
In this case, I'm using Siemens TI portal version 17. And let's create my controller first. And we can use the unspecified CPU. And we can automatically detect the controller. Then let's click this detect. I'm using the Ethernet cable connecting with this PLC. Okay, I searched my controller. The IP address is 1.181. Okay, let's click this detect. Click this consider as trusted controller. Okay, after this, let's go through this wizard. So we will get rid of the password and allow this security. And we will open this connection. And typically we will full access. Okay. And finish. And the IP address is 1.181. Okay. This three DCs, that means firstly DC, that means the power of this PLC. And the second DC, this is the input, the digital input of this controller. Typically for Siemens PLC, the second here, the all DC, this is 24 watts. And output here, this is third DC. This means this is transistor's output. The typical output of the voltage will be 24 watts. And then we will use the TO technology object to configure our high pulses. This can run as our channel driver. Okay, it's very convenient. So we can configure this high pulses output. So we will select the motion control and we will select the TO positioning axis. So I will select this automatic. As I introduced from other videos, for the 1200 PLC, it has a couple ways to control the drive. As we are introducing here, we are using the PDO high pulses to control the step motor. And we can also select the positioning unit. In this case, I'm going to control the motor. So I will use the degree as my unit. So I will switch to the degree. And then let's go to the drive. This area is very important. As we can see, this diagram very clear. So we need to deliver a PDO high pulse signal to the driver. This is exactly this black module I'm showing here. Okay, this is the microstep driver. Then we need to assign this pulse resources. Okay, we have four resources as I introduced. I will select the first one, resources, pulse one. Then based on these resources, we can assign the physical output. So as we can see here, for this output Q0.0, this PLC 1214 PLC, for this hardware Q0.0, it can do 100 kHz. I'm using this Q0.0 and the signal type. So let's look at this. The PDO, we have four types here. So typically for this lower end driver, one channel is a high pulses. The motor just run. It doesn't care the direction. And then another channel, we will control the direction, positive or negative. So typically we will select the pulses A and the direction B. That means one channel is mainly focused on the pulses. Another output is mainly focused on the direction. Okay, here we can select the channels according to the hardware I wired there. So the 0.0, I'm using the white wire, and the white wire go to the high pulses input of that module. So the output is a pulses output. And then I'm using Q0.1, the second channel, and I will control the direction. Okay, and here, active the direction control. And then this output enable, So as I introduced, default, this low-cost driver, that's enabled already. But in the industrial, a little bit high-end step motor driver, basically your enable must be on then to enable this driver. So in that case, you probably need to active this enable output. And in this case, I will not select this because this driver default that's enabled already. And this ready input, this is the feedback from the driver. So again, little bit high-end driver, some cases they will feedback one signal to the PLC. So this is the feedback channel. And default here, that true, that means we always assume this driver is enabled. That's why I select the true. So in your system, if you are using one driver that has the feedback ready to the PLC, then you can pick the input. So in this case, the enable and the feedback, we do not need that. So I do not need to select this. So more importantly, the Q0.0 is a high pulses and the direction is a Q0.1. Okay. Then let's go to this mechanics. This is the very important. This directly how many pulses will control one revolution. So hardware wise, as I introduced, in this case, my motor, this is 1.8. This is 1.8 degree per pulse. Okay. It also means for one revolution, this motor is 200 pulses per revolution. And in this case, if you recall, I'm selecting 32 microsteps. Microsteps. That means per revolution, if I'm going to control this motor to run one revolution, so the pulses I need to deliver to this driver will be 200 multiplied 32. That means this is 6400 pulses for one revolution. Okay, so here the pulses per motor revolution, I will select 6400. This is how many pulses for one motor revolution. Okay, but in the real case, maybe your motor is connecting with this lead screw here. Then one revolution from the motor side, your load will travel, maybe travel 10 or 0.1 millimeter. This depends on your lead screw selection here. In my case, if I send 6400 pulses, then the motor will run one revolution. And the one revolution, that is 360 degree, right? So this is my load, basically. So in this case, for my application, I should change to 360 degree, okay? This is this scaling here. This is the pulses per motor revolution. This is load per motor revolution. So my load represent the degree, so I'm selecting this 360 degree per motor revolution. So take care, all those base is a motor revolution. For some cases, if you always like the motor run one direction, then you can permit the positive or negative only. If we forward the motor, but your load will run backward, basically you need to invert this direction signal. So you can active this to invert your current direction. So you do not need to flip the signal on and off logic. So you only need to check this. If I find my motor run backward, then I will turn on this. And after this turn on, we will download this hardware configuration. Then let's go to others, position limits. So some cases you need the hardware or software limits. Okay, so you can active. In the dynamic option here, some cases you need to be care about this. I saw a couple cases, so people will complain why the step motor cannot run very fast. Basically, they saw the motor limited in a certain low speed. The most of cases because of this maximum velocity, because this is a logic-wise limit, the velocity of the motor can run the maximum speed like this. This value actually should come from the calculation of your system and your application and the gearbox. So all those things need to be joined together to come up the maximum velocity of your system. And this is start-stop velocity. And while you are doing the commissioning at the early beginning, you could also set this maximum velocity to a very low value. For example, I could set 360 degrees per second. That means the maximum speed from the PLC-wise, it can control this motor, the maximum speed is one revolution per second. So it won't cause any damage at the early beginning by some accident control command. This can limit your maximum velocity, okay? And then the acceleration, deceleration. So in this case, this time here, ramp up time, ramp down time is a little bit slow. I could set 1 second for the acceleration and 1 second for the deceleration, okay? Okay, I set this. And for others, emergency stop, we can set if your motor need to immediate stop. Okay, some cases, for example, I will set a 0.5 second for the ramp down time. So typically this allows your system to control drive, try its best to stop the drive. So this parameter or the deceleration here and with the time here. Okay, when we change this value, we will see this automatically calculated. For example, in this case, I'm going to change to 0.2 for the emergency stop. So the deceleration will be automatically calculated here. Then homing is a big topic. So I used a couple videos introduced before. Typically, we will use the passive. A very simple way, we can park the drive in a certain position, and then we can directly set to the target value. Typically, we can set a zero, set a position to this axis. Or some cases, to accurately find a home, your system has a home switch. Then we will control the motor run back towards the home sensor. And once touch the home sensor, this sequence will run automatically. Your drive will slow down and then running backward. Look at this. This is the negative direction. Running backward and try to touch the sensor again. Then run this sequence, we will find this home position very accurately. It is also a consistent way to find the home position. Then we will set a target home position value to the axis. So this is the active and the passive. Here it just very briefly introduced. Okay. So again, more importantly here, this is the drive configuration, which kind of hardware channel we will deliver this hypothesis. So I'm using Q0.0. Now I can download this configuration and then I can use the commissioning. I can use this control panel to control the PLC, deliver the pulses to control the step driver and the step motor. So without using any program, I can run the drive, I can run the motors. Basically verify if the PLC can deliver the pulses, if our hardware wiring is correct or not, if this driver can control this step motor properly or not. Basically to verify if the PLC, driver, motor, and the hardware connection, they are all connected well or not. Okay, so now let's download this PLC. I will download my PLC. All those configuration will be downloaded to this controller. Once we download the PLC, so we can click this go online. Then we go to this axis and go to this commissioning here. Okay, then we'll click this active. The active basically will allow the PLC ready to control this step motor driver. Okay, then we will enable. Click this enable basically behind, if you recall here. So the PLC will send the enable. But again, this step driver has been enabled default. So this enable is just logically internally enable everything. Allows this control panel to control the step driver, the step motor. Okay, let's enable. And to quickly verify, we can firstly use the jog. So we can forward and backward. And more importantly, we can verify if the forward backward running as the same as our definition. So typically we can run, for example, 1 revolution per second. And the acceleration, we can set 180. Okay, and then we can click this forward. Okay, as we can see, when I click the forward, the motor runs clockwise. And click this backward. Click. It's running backward. Okay, and meantime, we can watch this position and the velocity. Okay, after this acceleration, now the motor runs 360 degrees per second. Basically, 1 second, one revolution. Backward. And while we are doing this jaw control, we can verify the speed is running properly or not. This actually correlated with the configuration we did at the mechanics here, 6400. Now it's running one revolution per second after the speed is consistent. That means this 6400 is running properly. Some cases, if your calculation was wrong, for this 200 pulses and the micro step number, if you select the micro step wrong, so probably you will find the speed is not the same as your definition. The motor is 200 pulses. I'm using 22 micro steps. That's why per revolution of the motor, I need to deliver 6400 pulses. This is here. Okay, then go back to this commissioning. We can enable this motor again. To verify the speed more accurately, here we can go to the velocity specification. And in this case, for example, if I'm trying to control this motor faster or slower, typically to verify the speed, we can set the motor run a lower speed. For example, if I set this velocity 36, that means 10 seconds, the motor will run one revolution. If I configure everything correctly, if I click this forward, we will see the motor will use 10 seconds to run a full revolution. So let's verify that. And in the meantime, we can see this enabled and ready signal indicator. This is all logic wise, okay? So axis is at standstill status. Now let's trigger. If I click this forward, then you will see this arrow. Value at velocity parameter is invalid. Value is less than the config, the start-stop velocity. If we go to the configuration here, the value that stop you now is actually came from this. So we can change this value to a smaller value. If you have to run this motor slower, you can click the button and change the start value. But take care, the value here, just because all those values were changed here, this is used for the start value. The start value will be only active when the CPU from the stop to start. Then this turn will work, okay? So now if we stop this CPU and start again, then this start value will initiate those online value here, okay? Or we shift to the parameter wheel, we directly change the online value for this instant DB behind. But this is a little bit complex for the new learner. So to active some parameter you set here, take care, you better restart your CPU, then your new parameter will start work. So after we set 10 here, this time if we shift to the commissioning and let's active again, if I set a lower value for the velocity, 36, and same thing, I set 180 as acceleration deceleration. Now, if I click the forward,
we can verify if this whole revolution will take 10 seconds. For example, now so basically one revolution, it takes 10 seconds.
That verified the 6400 pulses per revolution. I configured there, this is workable. All right, to stop the drive, click the stop. It will stop, okay? Then we can control the position. Then we can shift to the positioning. But before we are doing the positioning, we need to define where is a zero, right? This is basically the homing concept.
So typically we can move the drive to a certain position. That position you define at a zero. For instance, in this case, I'm going to jog my drive, move this cursor to this position, and then I will define this position as a zero.
So I will forward using the jog.
Typically, I can define this position as my zero position.
Then we can shift to the homing. And I can define the zero, or you can set any value as your initial position value. So in this case, I will set here as a zero. Click this set home. Then this value will set to the axis. If we are using the step motor, we don't have any encoder feedback showing here that logically calculated based on your pulses. This is the open loop positioning system. This is the logically calculated. Okay, we set to zero. Then if we shift back to the positioning, now if I set the target position, let's run 180 degree. And here we have the absolute or relative. Relative means every time I trigger, it will run half revolution. But absolute, it will directly run here 180. If I click again, it won't run because it reached the 180 already. Firstly, I will try the relative. Click. Let's watch this position. Okay, it will do 180. Okay. If I click again, it will do another 180 travel. Okay. If I click again, do another 180. But absolute will run different role. Current position, it is 540. If I click this absolute, the motor will run backward one revolution towards to the 180, exactly 180 position. So if I click this absolute, let's watch this position. Okay, it will run backward towards to the 180 it was, 180 position, running the backward negative speed. Okay, this is the absolute and the relative difference. Okay, again, if I run the absolute, let's say 360, it will run the half revolution because we are currently at 180. If I click this absolute, it will run half revolution because its target is 360 degree. Okay, this is the absolute and the relative. And to use the step motor to run the positioning control, the absolute control and the relative control, they are typical two commands to control the step motor drive. If you can use this control panel to control your step driver and your step motor properly, that means all the configuration and all the calculation we configured before and this drive channel, they all correct. Then the next big step will turn to the programming. All right. This is the main topic in this video. How can we use the TI Portal 1200 PLC, the technology object, doing this PTO, high pulses output configuration to control the step motor driver and step motor. And since this video has been more than 30 minutes, it's too long. I will use the next video to show how can we use the program, the motion control program, to join the axis together to allow the program to control the step motor. See you in next video.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video, please give me a thumb up. If you like to watch more videos in my channel, please subscribe and hit the bell. Thank you for watching.